Jenny here. It's been a while since I've done a video. This is a thyroid cancer diary. This is my first entry and I'm vlogging about it. I've been hypo for 4 years, but I've always been energetic, happy-go-lucky, and driven. 34 years old, who loves people and life. I've been on a weight loss journey for over a year now, and I've been working out, doing really good, feeling okay most days. Then out of nowhere, fatigue hit me. Extreme exhaustion. I'd go to the grocery store, spend an hour in there, come home and not even feel like putting up my groceries. I'd have to actually sit and take me a break. And I was like, this is strange, this is not me. So, you know, you don't think nothing of it. So I brushed it off. And then one night, while laying in bed, I don't usually feel my body or anything, and I've lost over 50 pounds. I felt my neck and noticed a large lump. I asked my husband to feel it. He also felt it. So the next day I had a follow-up for lab works about my thyroid anyway. And my doctor hadn't been doing exams on my neck at any appointment for the past 4 years. So I feel like that should have been done. Definitely should have been done since I see her for my thyroid. And so I don't know how long the lump had been there. I started noticing that I was getting choked and eating and taking pills and water and all of that. It felt like it was getting stuck. I always had to keep clearing my throat, have a cough that came out of nowhere, and just feels like something's sitting there. Well, she examined it and she said, yes, that is definitely an enlarged thyroid gland. So she sent me for an ultrasound. That came back that there was two large nodules that needed to be biopsied, and the thought of having a needle stuck in my neck was terrifying. So they set me up for an FNA, fine needle aspiration. One of them was, you know, large, so they did my isthmus, and that one was okay. They numbed me up. The numbing stung, but just for a few seconds. It was really pressure is all I felt on this one. And then on this right side one, it was deep in my neck, and it's over a centimeter. So he had to really go digging around for that one. Had to get a bigger needle, had to numb me again. And that one was very unpleasant. I hope and pray I never have to do that again. It was terrible. You know, it was terrible having to do this one. I didn't feel pain. It was just pressure, a lot of pressure, and just at the very end, it started to cause me a lot of pain, and he was like, we're almost to it. You know, it was deep in there, and I'm not trying to scare anyone. I'm just sharing my real life experience for anyone else that might go through this so you know what to expect. Everyone's different. And he had to really get in there to get this one, and when he stuck it deeper, a pain shot from here all the way up to the front of my head like I had never felt in my life. And finally, he got it. So they sent that off, and I waited. I think it was about 5 days. My doctor called me and asked me to come in. And my results came up on my patient portal, and she blocked me from viewing it. So a red flag went up. Hey, this is not good. For some reason, she doesn't want me to see it before I speak to her, because she's never blocked any of my other tests. And so I went in, and she sat me down, and she said, I hate to tell you this, but unfortunately, your FNA came back positive for papillary carcinoma, papillary carcinoma. I always say the name wrong. And then you always hear, no cancer's good, but it's the best cancer to have. I hate when someone tells me that. Cancer is cancer, regardless of how curable it is. It's still numbing to hear that, hey, I'm not even 35, and here I am, healthy, loving life, trying to get myself healthy, trying to turn my fatty liver around, and then out of nowhere, this hit me. And it seemed like my life changed in what seemed like an instant when she told me this. I kept it together. My husband was waiting for me at the end of the hall. I went out and he hugged me, and I just broke down in his arms. And, you know, I have a lot of questions about this. And so now I am getting ready to have my entire thyroid removed. That itself is so scary to me. Not the surgery so much as my vocal cords, parathyroid glands and life after. I can't afford to gain any weight back because of my fatty liver. And my surgeon said, your main focus shouldn't be weight gain, and it shouldn't be your voice. It should be that this is malignant and we've got to cure you. And I'm like, I have fatty liver disease. I have to worry about my weight. I love being able to speak. Of course I'm going to be concerned about my voice. It's a scary thought to be put to sleep talking and wake up and, you know, you don't know what you're waking up to. I don't know if I'm going to be able to speak when I wake up. I don't know where that's going to go. I can only hope and pray that all goes well with my surgery. It's very scary. And I just want you to know, if you're going through this, it's okay to be scared. I am terrified at life after. So I'm going to start doing regular diary entries through video and posting them here on my Facebook. So please subscribe to my channel. I am not going to sugarcoat. I'm going to be straightforward. I'm going to document my entire journey, the good, the bad, the positive, the negatives, so that I can be a voice and help someone else. And like I said, my surgery is coming up fast. I'm so terrified of waking up to the unknown. But I know that if God brought me here, He's going to get me through it. And I just have this mantra, it is what it is. And I apologize for going so long with this video, but I need to vent. I need to try to help others, you know, who are going through this, to know it's okay to be scared. I'd be lying if I said I'm fine with it. I'm not scared. It's very scary because I don't know how my life is going to be after this surgery. I don't know if I'm even going to be able to speak. I don't know if I'm going to have to be on calcium and RAI. I don't know if I have to take that yet. On mine, they called and let me know that they didn't just find papillary carcinoma. They found some rare cells, and so I may have two forms of cancer. I don't know yet. I'm still praying that, you know, somehow I get a miracle from this, but it is what it is. Like I said, I'm going to update as often as I can, and I'm going to share all of it, this whole process, in hopes of helping someone else. So thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit that subscribe and the notification so you get notified when I upload. Have a good day, everyone.